A useful technique to prove that a theorem is true is a so-called proof by contradiction. You basically convert your original theorem into another equivalent one that's easier to prove. How does it work? You will learn this in this video, and we will also immediately apply this method to an example from linear algebra. So what's the idea? So you have a theorem where condition A implies that B is true. Equivalently, what you can prove is that the exclamation mark means not, so that not B, if B is not true, that this implies that A is not true. So you can either prove that if your condition is true, then your conclusion is true, or you can prove that if your conclusion is not true, then your conditions are also not met. So let's take a look first why this logical statement holds, why this is true. For example, we have the statement, if it rains, then the streets are wet. So A, condition, it rains. B, conclusion, streets are wet. So what would this statement over here mean in this case? Not B, so the streets are not wet, implies not A, it does not rain. So those are equivalent statements, and I think they're probably true, by the way. So if it rains, then the streets are wet, and if the streets are not wet, then it doesn't rain. So those two statements are equivalent. Note, the converse of the statement here is a different statement. The converse would be the streets are wet, then it rains. But that's not necessarily true. If the streets are wet, it could have a different cause. So that's why, to give you a feeling, why these two statements are equivalent. Now, what's an example of a proof by contradiction? Well, we have a theorem here. If AX is zero is only the trivial solution, then AX is B has at most one solution. So condition AX is zero has only trivial solution, and conclusion AX is B at most one solution. So your statement A, say, is, so your condition, your statement A would be here, AX is zero only trivial solution, and statement B would be here, AX is B has at most one solution. So equivalently, the negation of the second part is AX is B has more than one solution, and it implies a negation of the condition. So AX is zero is not only the trivial solution. And the second one is easier to prove, and that's what we're going to do. So we assume that the statement is not true. So we assume that AX is B has more than one solution. For example, 2. So we assume that AX is 1 equals B and AX2 equals B as well, where X1 is not equal to X2. Now, how are we going to show that the conditions are not met? Well, we do that as follows. We subtract them. So we get AX1 minus AX2 equals B minus B, because AX1 was B and AX2 was also equal to B. So we get B minus B equals 0. Then we have AX1 minus AX2. You can take out the A equals A times X1 minus X2 equals 0 vector. But now your AX0 has a non-trivial solution, namely X equals X1 minus X2 is now a non-trivial solution of AX0. So that means that your condition is not met, because it was given that it has only the trivial solution. This is leads to contradiction. By assuming that your condition is not met, you are contradicting your assumption. This means that your assumption is wrong. So this means that if AX is zero has only the trivial solution, then AX is B has at most one solution. So this is how you use a contradiction to prove a theorem.